Hello friends, welcome to GATE Agricultural Engineering classes on heat transfer. So today I am going to discuss the next part of this topic, which is related to convection heat transfer. So this is a brief introduction about me. So this thing I have already discussed, this question distribution, how the questions are asked. So from convection and dimensionless numbers, at least two or one questions generally asked in every year. We can see that one or two questions generally asked, so it is a very important topic. So these are some basic things that we have to study in convection. So I'm not going to discuss these all things. You can pause it and read it, these things. So these are some typical values of H which we need to remember, so as to check our answer. Sometimes like for gases, if questions are asked in free convection, if it is lying in this range, then we can cross check our answer. So these things are important in that manner. Then some dimensionless numbers are there which we must have to remember, like Nusselt number, Prandtl number, Reynolds number, Grashof number, Lewis number. You can stop the video and see these things. Okay, so these are some other numbers, and this is Biot number. So there is one difference in Biot number and Nusselt number, that this is an important difference, that thermal conductivity in Biot number refers to the conduction body, where in Nusselt number it is the conductivity of the convecting fluid. We'll discuss questions, then it will become more clear. So this is the question asked in the year 2007. It is very important question, you can say. And this question, see, in this question, this ice cream at a temperature of minus 18 degrees Celsius, it is transported in a refrigerated van. So this is the refrigerated van, and heat is getting transferred through convection here. We can see this is a refrigerated van, and there is no heat transfer through front and the back surface. So only this surface and this surface and the bottom surface is contributing to the convection. So here we have to find out the average heat transfer coefficient of this system, and everything is given, and the relation is also given here. So what we have to do here, just we have to put the values in this relation. That Nusselt number we know, HL by K. So the K for fluid is given, that's why it is Nusselt number we can calculate here, and H value we have to calculate. So what L should be, that is very important here. So in this kind of process, see, air is flowing in this way. So L, we have to take the length of this cart or the length of this wagon or the truck, we have to take as L, and the same L we have to take in this Reynolds number also. Okay, so in Reynolds number also we have to take L as this length of the cart. Okay, so mu value is given. V, what we have to take, V here it is given 90 km per hour, so we can convert into meter per second as 25 meter per second. So after putting all these values, and L will be 6, we have to put L as 6, we can easily apply to this relation, and we will get the value of H, and that H value we are getting as this 53.18 as the answer. And the next question is about the rate of heat transfer at the four surfaces. So for this rate of heat transfer, now we have H value, so we can directly apply the formula Q is equal to HA delta T. So Q is equal to H, we have already got A, we have to calculate A, we have to calculate by the area of these four surface, one this surface, top surface and bottom surface, because these four surfaces are the heat convecting surface. So these four surface area we have to take and add them up, and then delta T will be, see, the atmospheric temperature is 45 degree, and the temperature, outside temperature of truck is maintained as 15 degree. So we have to take the difference of 45 and 15 degree. So that will be 30 degree. So 30 degree we have to put to get the answer here. Okay. And the answer will be 95.7 after calculating this. So this will be the answer. So in that way we can solve this problem. So the next problem was asked in 2009. year 2009, and in this problem, see the convective heat transfer coefficient outside an ice cream block is 10 watt per meter square per Kelvin. So the H value is given to us, thermal conductivity is given to us, that is K. For ice cream, K value is given, means K solid you can think. Here convection takes place across the layer of 10 mm of air for 5 minutes. Okay, so 10 mm delta is given, that is 10 mm delta value is given, 10 mm. So what we have to find out here, if the density and the specific heat capacity is 600 kg per meter cube and 2.5 kg kilojoule per kg Kelvin. Okay, so what is the value? 0.33. so for this question, first we can directly neglect this answer, Nusselt number, because here I've told earlier that Nusselt number is calculated when this K is for the fluid, this K is for fluid in Nusselt number, while in Biot number this K is for the solid. Okay, so here K for fluid is not given, so we can directly neglect Nusselt number. Now we can check for Fourier number, Prandtl number. So we should know the formula for Fourier, Prandtl and Biot, but fortunately that directly putting the value H delta by K, this solid here, we are getting 0.33. so the answer will be Biot number, directly we can get the Biot number. Okay, so the next problem is on the basis of the dimensional the number in heat transfer corresponding to the Seroot number in mass transfer. So there is some relations like dimensionless number in heat transfer corresponding to the mass transfer. So for this is also a direct question. For Seroot number it is Nusselt number, which is the just corresponding to the Seroot number in mass transfer. Okay, so this all dimensionless numbers we need to remember, because mostly if you see the problems, they directly ask from the dimensionless number. 3-4 problems we have observed that are from the dimensionless number directly. Okay, in 2014 also you see again some in-depth question are asked. Here identify the incorrect statement about the relevance of the various dimensionless number in the transport process. Here first one, it is Reynolds number is relevant in forced convection and Grashof number is relevant in natural convection. That is true, that is true, because we know that in Reynolds number in forced convection we write this Nusselt number as a function of we write Reynolds number and Prandtl number. So this is okay in this case, and in free convection we write instead of this Reynolds number there comes Grashof number, so that is okay. Then the Prandtl number is relevant in heat transfer and Schmidt number is relevant in mass transfer. That is also true, that this thing Prandtl number is relevant in heat transfer while the Schmidt number is relevant in mass transfer. Then the third one is Biot number is relevant in heat transfer and Froude number is relevant in mass transfer. And the fourth one is Nusselt number is relevant in heat transfer and Seroot number is relevant in mass transfer. So this thing also true, we have observed this thing earlier, so this thing is also true. And this is also dimensional similarity, but about this it is not true. The Biot number is relevant in heat transfer while the Froude number is relevant in mass transfer. That is not true, because Froude number is also used in heat transfer. In unsteady heat transfer we use Froude number and Biot number both together, so that this will be the incorrect statement, so this will be the answer. Okay, next problem is this is here here very important question. Now this question is completely based on the difference in the Biot number and this Nusselt number and Biot number. Okay, so both have the same formula, but here see we have to calculate Biot number, so we have to take the thermal conductivity of glass, not the air. So we have to take 0.5 instead of 0.02, and this thickness of stagnant layer is given as 2 mm, so we can directly put the value as delta by K, and this H value is given to us as 0.5, delta is 2 mm, and K value is given as H is given as 10, this K value is given as 0.5, and this delta value is given as 2. So we will get the answer as 0.04. Okay, so this is very simple problem.
So
these are the few problems that are asked from heat transfer, convective heat transfer. So you just try to practice it, and if any further problem is there, please message me, and thank you very much.